The word research can be intimidating. Where do you begin? Well, what do you do when you have a question? A simple, close question might be, what's the weather today in Corpus Christi? Maybe you Google weather Corpus Christi to find the answer. Maybe you use an app or ask Siri, what's the weather? All of these are search strategies you could use to find the answer to this specific question. The answer is short, factual, with little room for interpretation. Other questions can be more complicated, and Google doesn't always give us a direct answer. These are called open questions. Open research questions, like what you'll be doing in the university classroom, requires you to find multiple pieces of information and piece them together to come up with a credible answer. This process can seem to take forever, but we're here to teach you how to be strategic to save you time and to help you find the most credible and suitable resources. That word strategic is important. What is a search strategy? A search strategy refers to the keywords, search engines, and limiters we use when searching for information. More generally, it's the what, where, and scope of our search. Keywords are the search terms you choose to use in the search bar. This is the what of your research. You want to use a combination of keywords together to start your research process, and you want to use that open research question for clues on where you should begin. Let's use Sam's question as an example. Sam might want to know about how sharks' portrayal in the media affects tourism here in Texas. If they search the word shark, they'll get millions of results talking about biology, conservation, and many other things that have to do with sharks. If they search the word media, that's going to be too broad because media can refer to many things. If they search the word tourism, they may get millions of results that are not related to Texas tourism. Therefore, they need to use a combination of all of these terms together to find relevant resources for their presentation. We also should be prepared with backup terms before entering a search. When explaining the most recent shark movie, Sam and I may use different words to explain it to a friend. Similarly, those who create content may use different terminology than what you're originally searching for. Brainstorming synonyms for some of these keywords can help you prepare to refine your search. For example, instead of using the word media, what if Sam uses the word movie? Maybe the movie The Meg or Jaws has had an influence on tourism. Maybe Sam would want to add the key phrase Gulf of Mexico to their search as well. In the next video, we're going to talk more about where to search for information and how to use this combination effectively. Pick one of three different open questions and brainstorm some keywords or phrases you might want to include when searching for information. Once you have your list, watch the video and see how our key terms might compare and contrast, and how our results might differ based on where we're searching for information.